just a few weeks ago, right? You were crowned?
Back in March. Yeah. So it's all kind of a whirlwind happening, but it's been great. And those ladies are lovely, as well as all the other contestants we had. Actually, a very big group this year. One of the biggest.
I saw a bunch of the photos and videos from the pageant itself, and you look like not only having a great time, but it was very well done. It was very cool.
Yeah, Deb Provenot puts on an amazing production for Mrs. Maine America, and they can get in amazing ladies throughout the state. And we just have been able to connect throughout the year to be able to kind of become friends along the way, which
That's
is great,
nice.
Too.
Yeah, and keep those friendships going.
Absolutely.
Now, let's talk about a little bit about yourself. Now, you're a lifelong Mainer, right?
I grew up in Northern Maine. I'm a county girl.
Yeah?
I grew up in the back neck of the woods of the potato fields. Originally from Easton.
Mm-hmm.
Grew up there, went to school, came down here to go to UNE in college. Graduated from there with a bachelor's degree in medical biology. Stayed down here. My husband, who moved down as well. Well, we weren't married at the time. We kind of were sweethearts from back in the day.
Oh,
and
nice.
And we just kind of developed a life down here. And a lot of our family members have also kind of moved down here. My mom and my brother, his brother as well. So we migrated, but his parents are still up there. And we're actually taking a trip up north this weekend.
Oh, that's a nice drive for Memorial Day weekend, right?
Absolutely.
So why don't you tell us a little bit about your platform?
Yeah, my platform is suicide prevention and awareness, which is something really close to my heart. I lost my dad to suicide when I was 3, so about 34 years ago.
Wow.
And I just feel that I could be the voice and someone out there to help people realize that there are help out there. There's help for, you know, counseling and things like that, that you don't have to turn to taking your own life to solve your problems. And, you know, depression plays a big thing with that. So I actually am having a training of the trainer for suicide prevention and awareness with NAMI today. I'm looking forward to that and being able to be a voice for that in our community.
Yeah, there's so many great organizations.
Absolutely.
It's good to get that word out.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for that. That's great. Now, you're going to be representing Maine, of course, at the Mrs. America pageant, and that's what, in September?
That is September 26th. There's been a lot of up in the air of where it's going to be.
Uh-huh. Yeah, did I hear Russia at one time?
You have heard correct. Actually, this marks the 25th anniversary of a joint pageant between Mrs. America and mm-hmm. Mrs. Russia to kind of commemorate and have a peace treaty back in 25 years ago.
Right.
And so the word is that it's going to be in actually Crimea.
Wow.
Sevastopol. And we're kind of fingers crossed hoping that it'll come back to the United States, but it's a once in a lifetime opportunity. So I'm looking forward to wherever it may be.
That would probably be a lot of work getting ready for that, wouldn't it?
I mean, absolutely.
Wow.
You know, the nervous part would be getting everything over there in one piece.
Exactly. Just the transport of the stuff.
Yeah.
Not so much you, but the stuff.
The stuff, which would have to be packed into a carry along because I don't want to run the risk of having it go and be lost.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the only unnerving. Once we find out for sure, definitive, yes, this is where it'll be, I'll get a little bit more comfortable. Okay, the preparations will begin.
Now I'm just thinking, Russia in September, what's the weather like?
I don't even know.
That time of year.
I'm hoping maybe kind of fall. Still on the tail end of warmth. Yeah. I have no idea.
Now, if it's not in Russia, what's the backup plan for that? Do you
know? The past 5 or 6 years, it's actually been in Tucson, Arizona.
Oh,
so
that's a nice plan.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'd be pulling for plan B myself. But still, the traveling is nice, though. That would be really, that's a once in a lifetime opportunity.
Hawaii, it's been in Las Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
So fingers crossed.
A little different than Presque Isle.
I don't think there'd be too much up there.
Now, you said you're judging a pageant in Presque Isle this weekend, right?
So. Yeah, so I'm going up to judge Miss Vacation Land.
Oh, very nice.
It's going to be held on Saturday. I'm looking forward to that. It's a pageant for all ages. So. Mm-hmm. Getting excited for that.
Well, thank you, Lori, for coming in this morning.
Well, thank you for having
me. Great meeting you.
And nice to meet you as well.
Best of luck with the suicide awareness and prevention platform.
You.
It's such a great thing to get that word out.
Absolutely.
And, like I said, and you're going to be training with NAMI today. So that's really cool. Thank you very
much. Well, thank you.
We'll follow you and let us know how things are shaping up as we get closer to September.
I certainly will.
Thank you. Lori Ajulo-White, Mrs. Maine America.